Hey, Tony from Songwriters Chop Shop here. In this video, I'm going to be talking about how the King of Hooks, Max Martin, goes about writing a melody. And if you're looking for weekly songwriting tips, tools, and techniques, be sure to hit the subscribe button. When it comes to songwriting, according to Max Martin, melody is king. Writing the melody first gives me more freedom than doing it the other way around. It's very important to have a great melody. If you have one, build your song around that. Don't make it too complicated. So how does Max Martin come up with great melodies? Bonnie McKay, co-writer of hits like Teo Cruz's Dynamite and Katy Perry's Teenage Dream, said, "When Max sings a demo, he sings nonsensical stuff, just phonetically pleasing lyrics. Max really taught me a lot about the importance of symmetry and melody. The hook line in Teo Cruz's Dynamite was Max's phonetic bumbling. This seems to be something Max has always done." Talking about Max's first number one hit, Britney Spears said, "All the hooks of the song were worked up to their finished state, but most of the verses were unfinished, often mere vowel sounds." So what's the reason behind this? Max says, "If you can have a great lyric that also phonetically sounds amazing, then you're golden. But it's also kind of cool if you can write a song and people are emotionally moved without understanding what's been said. That, to me, is powerful. If we come to a place in a writing session where one word might make better sense, but the other option sounds cool, I will always pick the one that sounds appealing to me." But this approach isn't just unique to Max Martin. Legends like David Bowie and Stevie Wonder have even admitted to using this approach. In an interview about working on his hit album Uptown Special, Mark Ronson said this, "Lots of times we had a melody already. We would record a sketch vocal with nonsense words but very specific vowel sounds, because certain melodies work better when they're sung with certain sounds." So it seems this approach is widely used in the industry. It's called phonetic singing. So what exactly is phonetic singing? Well, let's have a look at it in action with this clip from Sia, and pay close attention to the vowel sounds she uses.
So then that's all we would do.
That was good.
That was mental. Can we have a copy of that?
Nice work.
So da 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 dee do dee do da 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 da. That to me was the hook in the chorus. That's the bit that for me people would hear on the radio, and that's the bit that would stick in their head and they would sing. Just instantly my feeling around that was like, oh, this is the hook. So then I would find a word.
This might look pretty simple, but remember, simple isn't always easy. In an interview with Rolling Stone, Sia said, "It took me 15 years to take 20 minutes to write a song." And while she wrote Rihanna's Diamonds in under 15 minutes, for Rihanna to replicate her demo, it took 2 days. So to Max, these vowel sounds can make or break a melody. The emotion of the lyric and melody lives in those vowel sounds, and to Max, that sound is more important than the meaning of the word. "Growing up, I listened to songs by ABBA, Elton John, The Beatles, and I had no idea what they meant. So to me, phonetics have always been important. I felt something hearing this music, and it meant something to me." Melodies are carried by vowels. Vowels hold emotions, and emotions are what connects with people. Try it out with your own melodies. Start with the melody and use vowel sounds instead of words. But like I said, don't be fooled. Simple isn't always easy. This method takes practice, and you may end up sacrificing the intellectual meaning of a word for the emotional feeling of its sound. It's not right and it's not wrong. It's just one way to do it. You decide what's more important, the intellectual meaning or the emotional. emotional sound. And if you don't like the thought of using nonsense words, remember, even Shakespeare did this. So play around with it. Certain words sung in a unique way can also make a hook. A really obvious example of this is David Bowie's Changes, and Max is all about the hooks. Now, if you want to find out how Max builds a full song around a melody, check out this video, link below. If you enjoyed this video, hit the like button below, and if you know someone that would benefit from watching it, be sure to share it with them. So let me know in the comments, what's your favorite Max Martin hook? And be sure to sub for new videos every week. Okay, catch you next time.